Hello, Senior Stoner fans. It's the real Senior Stoner back at you. Today is Monday. Welcome to your dab of the day. In case you don't know, that's I'm Still Standing, because I'm still standing, and it's not fun. But I want to get to the topic of day and not talk about my health today. Let's just let it be said that I'm in incredible pain. So, the topic of the day, something we've touched on, we've kind of looked at the periphery. Because we've talked about holidays, we've talked about, you know, being alone and things like that, but we weren't really focusing on the specific topic, loneliness. Because loneliness can happen whether you have people around you or not. A lot of research has been done about loneliness. Loneliness is not a disease. It's kind of a condition. It's kind of where you end up and it becomes a trained response. You're lonely and you feel lonely and you don't try to do anything about it. You kind of become lonely, and that's okay. But it's not okay. Because there are different extremes. There's slightly lonely, there's moderately lonely, and there's extremely lonely. Okay? And there's actually a loneliness scale, believe it or not. So, people, it isn't about just having other people in your life. It's about having compassion in your life. It's about having the ability to care for somebody else in your life, to share your concern for others, not just get the concern from others. I think helping yourself by helping others could be the most important concept of loneliness. There's an old saying, airlines have used it for many years, put on your oxygen mask and then the child's. So you got to take care of yourself and then you can help others. And I think any of you on this channel who've been helping others know the good feeling you get from that, and it leads to less loneliness or less degrees of loneliness. So there's another thing we have to talk about with loneliness. It's the stigma. That's right, the social stigma. Because when you're lonely, it implies that you don't know how to make friends. It implies you have no friends. It implies you have nobody. And people tend to look at that and say, well, when you discuss loneliness, those are people who are by themselves all the time. Well, guess what? That's not what it is. How about if you do things by yourself a lot? That doesn't mean you're by yourself. You're lonely because you choose sometimes to do things by yourself. I've been like this for many, many years before all this started, that I would choose to do things myself. On a Friday night, before I took the guys out in New York City for entertainment, I would go to a movie by myself. So there might have been some loneliness there, but it was a slight loneliness. It wasn't the degree of loneliness I feel now sometimes, or that I expect many of you feel. So I guess what we have to ask is, what's the point of loneliness? And what is it an indication of, and what can we do to stop the drivers around it? Because here's what's happening. Loneliness, I believe, changes us. We become accustomed to being alone. Our minds, our bodies, we might dress differently. For example, not as nice. We might not groom as much. Nobody's around. And we expect, therefore, to stay lonely. So it becomes a conditioning thing. So it's highly personal and private loneliness, but when you reach the point, because we as human beings are sociable creatures, the cavemen were sociable creatures. So we have to find a way. I guess it's when the body reaches the alert state. Flight and Fright from Tyrannosaurus Rex, when the alert state is, oh my God, I have no one, or something to that effect, you realize you're too lonely. And then you try to come back the other way. What I'm trying to do here today is talk about the condition so we all don't go that far and have to work our way back. Recognize the drivers, what the things you're doing are that be called loneliness, so you know that you're there already. So you don't have to get into a deep, dark state of loneliness like I've been in. okay? Remember, not always about a physical injury, okay? It could be about a living arrangement. It could be about not having a social network. Very, very personal. Well, what is the survival thing that we get when we feel lonely? What does it do to us? Well, if you do hit that wall, that lonely wall, studies have shown that what happens is you bounce back. It's almost like drugs and alcohol. If you're not going to, unfortunately, get to the point where it's really too late, you hit bottom, it's called, and then you come back. So with this, it's very important to understand that there's a point you can come back from. And I believe there's a point you can't come back from. You have to make sure you don't get to that point. Because here's what happens. There's an increased risk of death early in life for people living alone. And that was a 3.5 million person study. Okay? What that means is you got to do everything you can to touch others. Well, I know many of you on the channel live alone, but you work and you have contact with people during the day and you have lives. So that's a very important thing. Senior centers, things like that. You know what? They're okay. They're going to give you human contact. You got to find it wherever you can. If you're a jogger, you're going to find other people jogging. But you still might be lonely because you don't talk to them. So I think what happens here is that friends, neighbors, relatives and friends that aren't that close, acquaintances, let's call them, won't see that you're lonely, won't understand what you're going through, and may even think that you're an asshole and you don't want to talk. But you're lonely, and loneliness breeds more loneliness and breeds more loneliness, and you want to get back into it, okay? And loneliness could be looked at as the difference between what you want in relationships and what you actually get. You know what I mean? It's this feeling of sadness almost, that you have something that you've left on the table that you haven't eaten or you haven't taken that's yours. This loneliness thing is not saying we're incapable of social activity. It's saying that if you get caught in that box, in that term, loneliness, you got to find a way to ratchet it back somewhere the other direction. Not saying it has to be done all the way. Not saying you're going to become a happy person and have friends and people around you instantly. But loneliness can be a spiral. Don't let it be a spiral down for you. Let it be a trigger. Your feeling of loneliness is okay to have because it's going to bring you the need to be with other people. This is the Real Senior Stoner. Let's take our dab of the day. Here we go. Let's see what we have left over here. We have, looks like some California delicious batter. Let's have a hit of the delicious California batter in our Puffco Peak this morning. Hello, everybody. I'm here for you so you don't stay lonely. I'm here for you so I don't stay lonely. It's important we think like that. What people don't think I think, what I don't think people catch is they don't catch themselves and you fall too deep, too quick. And hopefully that's what this is helping. So that if you're already lonely, you don't fall off the deep end and become severely lonely, which could be called something else. Okay? Let's get back in the game, everybody, and do the best we can. So all I can ask you to do, so all I ask myself to do the best you can. Cheers. You can always pick up the phone and call the senior, 908-698-7418. Text me, I'll text you back. Anybody can validate that I return all my calls. I don't say it just for the hell of it. This is the Real Senior Stoner back at you. Have a great day, everybody. And remember, if you're lonely, it's not a bad thing, but you got to find a way to move it the other direction. Cheers.